always, yeah, GQ is such a fantastic place to be there. It's extraordinary style. And it's always wonderful, yeah, when it's when you're vouching for the man of the year. Very easy. It's simple. It's Ranveer for me. Hands down. Thanks, Amit. Two, generally. It's transparency and honesty, and number one. And not trying too hard at number two. And being a feminist at number three. And yeah, I think that winds it up for me completely. Yes, absolutely. You're talking about my experiences and my journey. And where I was and where I've come today. I think for me it'll most importantly be about where I was and where I've come as a person, as a human being. First, and how much I've progressed there. And how much I've evolved there. Because if I haven't done that, I don't have anything to write. Build up. sure. Haan, boli. Yes. Yes.
What made you to come out and say, and probably can this be a part of the thing?
Absolutely. The reason I came out now was because when the whole fiasco was happening, I was pregnant. And you know how they say that you need to be having great energy, the best energy around you, in your mind, in your mind space, in your thoughts. And I don't think it was the right time then for me. I wish I could, but I also am happy that I could do it now. I didn't want to then involve myself in a scenario like this and have negativity around me of any sort. I was in a happy place and I just found this to be the right time to share it. I always wanted to share it. I'm not somebody, Sumit, you know, I don't shun away from sharing personal experiences. And if I can encourage other women, you know, to stand their ground, to learn the meaning of no and have the courage to say it, come what may, no matter what. I'd be more than happy to be a part of their journeys by maybe encouraging them a wee bit. So, yeah. Thank you. So, honestly, I didn't make any comparisons because season one was a season one, and season two was obviously going back and forth like season one, and in a way it was a prelude to a lot of stories, a lot of tracks, a lot of plots, a lot of lives that were not touched upon or explored in season one. So I would say every character holds their ground in season two. They've given a whole new sort of a turn to season to the plot with season two and to the book from the original. And I think it's found its own niche audiences. I don't think in the minds of the makers the attempt was to please all, because you could never do that. And the comparison obviously between a first in a franchise and a second is always going to be there. The first, if it does well, comes as a surprise, you know. And it was a surprise to our Indian audiences that something like that could actually be created in our very own country by our own makers originally. So the comparison I understand is very, very natural, but it's best not to compare and look at season two, not in comparison, but as a whole story in itself, and for that I think we did fabulously. Thank you. Sure. I have no idea, you'd have to ask the makers that. I don't know, I mean, being a part of the cast myself, I have very, very little information on that, but I'm sure when the makers are ready to announce whether there is one or isn't one, you'll know.
Thank you.